All right, so welcome back to the channel, and let's talk about, this is the third and last video for today's, or this week's topics, which is working with sensors with Arduino. And in this tutorial, we will work with the ultrasonic sensor. And if you have seen an ultrasonic sensor, then you will notice immediately the one difference compared between it and other sensors. For example, if we look at, this is the last circuit that we built last time, so I'm gonna show you the ultrasonic. Now, the ultrasonic sensors, I'm gonna write it here. So there's actually ultrasonic. Okay. So as soon as you, first of all, there's two different types of ultrasonic sensors, and we need to understand which one we're gonna be working with. This, as you can see clearly right now, you might see that in Tinkercad, there is actually two ultrasonic sensors. One with the usual configuration. You have ground, power, and then the signal, which is the output. And then you have this one right here, which has four pins. Well, let us begin by saying that we will not work with this one, because this one is only the ping, or it's the old fashioned, or the old one. We will not use this one. We will work with the HC-SR04 ultrasonic sensor. The very first thing you will notice that this sensor has four pins rather than three. Let's clear them out of the way. First of all, this is the power source. This is where we receive the power, and this is the ground. And then these two are the two sensors, or the two values that we're going to use in order to measure the distance. The ultrasonic sensor actually is used to measure distance. It's exactly in the same principle as the submarine. It uses ultrasound or echo to measure the distance. How does it work? Well, you can see that there is actually two of those. You have that these two circles actually has a purpose. One of them is a transmitter, in other words, the ping, and the other one is the receiver or the echo. And how does it work? How does this sensor work really? This kind of sensor is different than the first two sensors we worked with. In the first two sensors, the device simply measures a value and then we display it straight away. We capture the value and display it. So the value that the sensor captures is what is the information we're looking for. Temperature sensor captures temperature. Light sensor captures the light illumination. But this ultrasonic sensor does not measure a distance immediately. It does not have a way to measure distance directly. Instead, it uses some raw data, in this case, the time and the sound and all that stuff, in order to measure distance. How does it work? Well, the ping shoots a sound, or a ping, or a quick shout, but we cannot hear it with our ears because it's ultrasonic. Ultrasonic means beyond the sound range. We cannot hear it ourselves with our own eyes, but it sounds like a ping, like a ping, and it shoots in the space until it hits the object, and then the echo comes back to the receiver. So the transmitter shoots the ping and hits it, and then the sound returns, and the receiver picks up the echo, ping, echo. And then based on the time the ping and echo came back, and based on the speed of sound, we can measure the distance. You see, in from physics, velocity or speed is equal to distance divided by time. So if you already know the velocity and if you already know the time, then you would know the distance. If I can go here and I can actually show it to you. Actually, it's right here. See, I can just add one more addition here. Can say that velocity is equal to distance divided by time. Is that right? Well, if you already know the velocity, which is in this case the speed of sound, and if you already measure the time it takes for the echo and ping to come back to you, then knowing these two, the time and the speed and the velocity, we can then find out the distance. And that's how, in a rough shell, how the ultrasonic sensor works. It shoots an echo, shoots a ping, and then waits for the echo, and then counts the time. And based on the time it took for the sound to come back, and based on the speed of sound, which is available to us, then we can then measure the distance. And this concept, by the way, is used in submarines and sonar and et cetera, et cetera. And you can actually read more about this in this slide and how it works. Now, whether we are using the speed of sound in metric units or in inches, we can then measure. But if you're using metric units, then the distance you're going to measure in the end will be in meters or centimeters or whatever conversion you're going to use. But if you're going to use the American units, which is in this number right here, then it will be in inches. Of course, you can always take the inches and convert to cm or millimeter. It's fine. So now, hopefully, it will make sense to you about these components or what's going on here. You can see that this is actually the trigger or the ping, and this is the echo. Or if we go to Tinkercad, you can see these components again. So once again, this is the VCC, and this is the ground, or this is the power, and this is the ground, and this is the trigger and echo. Since the trigger, we initiated ourselves. We tell the sensor when to shoot the trigger. So this is basically controlled by us, and the echo is received. So obviously, one of them is an input, one of them is an output. So that's how this sensor is different slightly than the other sensors we worked with. Okay, so let's use this sensor. Let's actually build a circuit around it and then use it or program it to measure a distance. So let's do that. Or if you don't want to go through that yourself, if you would like to see it ready-made, we can do that. So let me just, now I want to show you something else in Tinkercad, which is amazing. You probably have seen it already, but in fact, you can always find out ready-made tutorials. Let's just clear, you can always find out ready-made projects. So if you don't like, if you can see here, if you just search for ultrasonic, you can see that there's already a circuit already built for ultrasonic, which actually can, but unfortunately this one right here is the old ultrasonic. So does not really serve our purposes. So we're gonna have to build the one that we need. So I'm gonna throw away this one and yeah, let's clear the program that came with it, and essentially we're gonna start fresh. And we can actually use the program that is already in the slides, which is available right here. So let's actually build this circuit right here. So of course we could always use the breadboard if you would like, if you plan to use the value from the sensor to control something else, or you can just connect directly to the board. For the simplicity of it, I'm just going to connect directly to the board. So I'm going to follow the instructions from here. So here's my Arduino, and here's my ultrasonic, the proper one, which is this one right here. Yep. And I'm going to move it. Yep. Okay. So here we're good to go. And let's see. So according, let's follow the instructions from the slides. So where does the VCC go? So the VCC goes to 5 volt. Okay. So this one right here goes to the power. So here we go. Power and 5 volt. And the next will be the ground. Let's find any ground. So this one will be also go to the ground. Yeah, this one right here goes to the ground. It's okay if the lines go on top of each other. It's fine. They're not connected. Once again, as per usual practice, the power will be red and the ground will be green. Okay, so what else? The trigger, where does it go? The trigger goes to pin 11 and the echo goes to 12. Okay, so the trigger, which is right here, goes to 11. And let's give it a blue, and the echo goes to 12, which is right here, and let's give that a black. So here we go. So we have actually connected all the programs. See if there's any code here. There's nothing. Okay, so now what we're gonna do right now, we actually connected the circuit, but we cannot run the program yet. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna actually try to recreate the same program that we did before. So we're gonna set up the pins as well as some initiate values. So I'm gonna follow the mood here. So trig trig for pin, echo pin, and duration cm in inches. Let's do that in the program. So let's start with making some constant values and initial values as well. So it's gonna come here and do this, and come here, and these are actually copied from another program. I'm gonna change the values now. So we're gonna do trig pin and echo pin. And the values or the variables, it's not just sensor value anymore. It's gonna be, what was that? Long, which is a different kind of float. So duration, cm, and inches. Okay, let's just do that to here. So we're gonna go to long and duration, cm, and inches. All right, and essentially, so this is the values that we put here, which is duration and cm and inches. I think this program shoots or produces the distance in both metric and American units. Okay, so some initial values here, and we throw away the comments for now. And the trigger, we said just now, it was the trigger was 11. Yeah, the trigger was 11. And the other one was 12. Okay, good to go. So these are the values. Then we're going to do some setup. So void setup. And let's check out again what's going on here. Serial and then pin mode. You notice, like I said before, the trigger is an output, but the echo is an input. And that's important because the trigger shoots the sound, but the echo waits for it and receives it. So that's why one of them is an input, one of them is an output. Serial is already here, so I'm just gonna take this one out and paste and paste. And then one of them is an output, one of them is an input. So I'm gonna come here and change this to N. And which was the input? In this case, the echo. Is that right? Yeah, echo is the thing. And let's follow the good practice of not using capital letter in the beginning. Why? It's a long story. I'm not gonna go through that right now, but let's just do that. So echo is the input and trig is the output. Okay, what's next? And then we can actually follow the same code that we have here. Digital write shoot the pin. We have to cause the pin to shoot, so let's just do that. So I'm gonna void loop. I need a void loop here. So this one from another previous program, I'm gonna throw away all of this. Oh wait, not throw away all of this. I'm gonna keep the display value that, and then I'm gonna throw away this. This is from the last program. Okay, so now we have to follow this. So digital write and then delay, and digital write and then delay. And digital write and then, yeah, let's do that. So digital write three times. Digital write for trig pin, trig pin, trig pin. Essentially what's going on here is that we are shooting the trigger or the echo. We are shooting the ping. So that's why it's already switched off. And then for 5 microseconds, switched on for about 10 microseconds and switched off again. That's what it, so why language is shoot high? Well, it will not be counted as a ping if it wasn't already off. So these two offs, so what's going on? These three lines right here, we are basically using it to shoot a ping. A ping is simply is something like that sounds like this. Very quick shot. And in order to ensure that it's a ping, we'll have to make sure that it's already off and then before and after. So digital write off, digital write off, and then in between digital write on, and there's gonna be some delays in between. So let's do that here. So shoot the ping at the object. Digital write, and that will be the trig pin low. and then delay, what's that? Microseconds, is that right? Microseconds, and then we're gonna say 5. And then we're going to repeat this process a couple of times more. Copy. And here we go. And here we go. So this one, we'll switch it back on to high. And we're going to put a 10-second delay here. And then there's no need for this one, but I'm just going to keep it here because it looked cool. So that was the... We already shot the beginning. Now, next we're gonna do is that we're gonna have to actually capture the echo. So that's why pin mode, we're gonna have to detect the value. It's supposed to be digital read, is that right? I'll do it anyway. Okay. I think this is supposed to be digital read, but I'll or pin mode. Okay, we'll follow it anyway. So. Capture echo, and that will be pin mode echo pin. Input. Oh yeah, we are basically changing the mode in order to tell it. That's exactly what was here, right? Yeah, I think there's a small mistake in this program, but I'll run it anyway, and then what we do after that is duration, pulse in, echo. Okay, so duration equal to pulse in. I have a feeling that this would not work because it's a library, I think. Yeah, I think it's a library. Let's try it anyway. So pulse in, and then we're gonna put, yeah, echo pin. Hi, yeah, hi. I think this function is missing from here. I think this is a function that actually does the job, but I think this code will not work, but I'll just do it anyway. And then after we capture the echo, then measure distance. And we're gonna do it twice, CM equal to duration 29.1. Okay, so it's gonna be duration. Yeah, duration divided by 2 because the echo and the sound takes one way and then back. So you have to divide it by 2 and then multiplied by or divided by the speed of sound in metric. So that will be divided by 29.1. Yeah. And don't forget the semicolon. And then here we're gonna get inches equal to the same line, but we're gonna change the number here. So copy duration divided by 74.0. If you put 74, it will be confused because that's double and 74 is an integer. Okay, and then display inches, and then we're going to do all that. Display distance reading, okay, and that will be CM, and then here is going to be CM, not a new line, but instead we're going to do this, and we're going to simply copy this guy and put it here. And this we're gonna in now put inches. inches, and in here, and no comma, but instead we're gonna put a new line here. I have a very big feeling that this will not work, but yeah, because this right here is not defined. I think it's a library. Yeah, exactly. It doesn't say what pulse in is, so error expected, function duration was not declared in the scope. Duration was already declared out of here, but then here is, it's a function. A declared pulse in was not declared, so yeah. Okay, so this is the program. Let's try again. And we're getting this error. And obviously, if you look at the error code, you see there's a bunch of errors here. So let's look for the first errors, that inches, cm, and duration were not declared properly. It means these guys are not defined properly. Look closer, you see error unexpected, unqualified before ID. Okay. There is no need for equal because this is the type of variable. These are the variables. If you don't use equal, means you have to do it after the name of the variable, not before. So like this, this will be zero. But then no need. I just not want to initiate the values, but we don't want to assign any values. Okay. So now with this, run the program. Okay, it works, and as you can see, the sensor actually does work. So if you zoom out a little bit, so how do you actually work? You run the program and you click somewhere on a sensor and you can see this is the object. So if you move the object around, you can see the values change. But if you take the object outside the range of the sensor, it will not update the value. Same thing here, but it only updates the values as long as the item or the object is in within the range of values. So let's recap what happened here. The echo or the trigger shoots the sound, the ping to the object, and the echo comes back here. And based on the type of the speed of sound, then we can measure the distance. And programming wise, we define the pin for the trigger, the echo, and some initial values, the duration, the distance in cm, the distance in inches. I personally don't like to use cm in inches like this. I would rather use distance cm, distance inches, to be more informative. And then, in fact, we do that just now. So, distance cm and distance inches. And then don't forget to come down in the program and update it. So down here will be distance in cm. And we copy it again here. And then this will be distance in inches. And don't forget to also update it here as well. So this will be right here. Run again, and it's working fine again. So once again, this is how you use the ultrasonic. Now, once again, what we did was we just measured basically this is what I meant by that the sensor does not directly measure distance, but it measures something else and then does some math and then gives us the value. So this is called indirect sensor values. So these are the raw sensor value, which is the trigger and the echo. And then the sensor does some math here along as well as some using some constant, which is the speed of sound. And then based on that, it gives us the output W1, which is a distance in cm or the distance in inches. Now, if you would like to work further with this, the value, then we can do a lot of things. We can say that if too close LED on, and if too far, then LED off. Or if you don't like to work with LED, then you can actually work with other things such as a motor or a sound. Here in Tinkercad, they do have a sound, so I suggest they actually go through the items and look for it. In fact, let's take a look at it now. If you go to all, and you can actually see that generally, then you have input, which is the potentiometer and other sensors. Then you can also have output, which is apart from LED, you can also have RGB LED, which is, by the way, multicolor LED, light bulb, NeoPixel, and then those guys, and then numbers. And finally, you can also have a sound, which is, I think, and you have DC motor can turn. You can also have micro server and server. And then obviously, you can also have the piezo, which actually makes a sound. So essentially, you can actually trigger all of these things based on the sensor value. So it's not always just LED. All right. And essentially, this is now the continuing or the completion of the three tutorials. So now you can then proceed. You can now proceed and do exercise 7.1 and 7.2. In 7.1, you're supposed to develop a street light sensor that monitors the surrounding light intensity and then switch out an LED on the surrounding skid dark. We actually already did that, but then do it yourself. And then here, develop a car reverse sensor system that monitors the distance in an object and then sounds a buzzer when the object gets too close. And then this is basically your case. Now, by the way, these two statements, they did not actually specify an exact value. What is dark? What is light? It's up to your definition. Same thing here. What is too close, too far? It's you define that yourself. For example, in if you go back to here, what is too close and too far? It depends on the value that you set yourself. Maybe 174, according to you, maybe this is maybe too close. Maybe this is too close. Maybe this is too far. It's up to you, as long as within the range of the values. So example, here is the absolute smallest value, and this is the maximum value. So you can actually select somewhere in between that we consider as too slow or too low. Or maybe you can choose this as your minimum value. It's up to you, really. So there's no specifics on which value is the one with it. Okay, so with this, now we ended part two, which is chapter seven, working with sensors. And then you're now ready to work with multiple sensors and then using those sensors as well. All right, thank you very much, and I'll see you in the next video.